الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise him, we seek help from him, we ask forgiveness from him, we repent to him, and we seek refuge in him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And anyone who has been misguided, you will never find a guardian to guide him. I bear witness that there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without any partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his messenger. O Allah, let your prayer, your peace and blessing be upon your servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. A continuation of the series of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ethics, today we're going to address the ethic of tilawat al-Qur'an, recitation of al-Qur'an al-Kareem. Recitation of the Quran al-Kareem is a form of worship. When you recite the Quran al-Kareem, you get rewards. For every letter, you get hasana, and every hasana worth of 10 hasanat. The scholars calculated the letters in the page, it's 15 lines. And if every line has about 30 letters, the calculation of all the rewards that you get for every page you recite of Quran Kareem is 4,500 hasana. From just every page you recite of Quran Kareem. Recitation of Quran Kareem is not just reading. Is different between reading and reciting. Reading including reciting, but reading is not a reciting. Reciting the Quran Kareem is slowly and surely to understand the meanings. So the tilawa, called it tilawa, Arabic recitation, that you read. You read the Quran, so you could get the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِالتَّوْرَاتِ فَاتْلُوهَا إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. This means recitation or reading. And also, the recitation or tilawa has a different, another meaning, means following. وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا. Mean that the moon following the sun. And also another meaning means the action, the work. الَّذِينَ أَتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابِ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. It means يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. It means they apply it, they work it the way it should be. And also another meaning means that to narrate or to talk about. وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينَ عَلَى مُلْكُ سُلَيْمَانَ. And they followed what's been said about from the devils about the kingdom of Solomon. Now, and also it's about descending. The fifth meaning, نَتْلُوا عَلَيْكَ مِنْ نَبَئِ مُوسَى وَفِرْعَوْنَ. Means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descending the news about Prophet Musa and Pharaoh. So when you recite, you need to beautify your recitation. Not just reading it like regular reading. This is the reason that when people hear the Quran without even knowing the meanings, they feel it with their heart. Because the Quran to the heart immediately when it is coming from the good source. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated that the that even that if this Quran will descend on a in a mountain, can you imagine the big mountain is going to crumble, it's going to diminish, it's going to, but you could imagine what kind of heart of a believer that will receive this Quran and will accept it. This means that you could see the powerful a powerful heart that will hold the Quran and will feel it and will benefit from it. So comparing the mountain that will crumble and will be demolished if the Quran would descend on it, and if the Quran comes on the hearts of the believer, the heart of the believer will be enough. Even Allah Subhanahu wa Taala said that the heart of the believer is the one who will convince and will understand the relationship with Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. So you need to beautify recitation of the Quran al-Kareem, and to do the best for that. The recitation, there are several. When you recite the Quran al-Kareem, there are several ways. There's tartil, and we just mentioned them in Arabic, and then I will say the meaning in English. Tartil, wal-hadar, wal-tadwir, wal-tahqiq, wal-zamzama. Tartil is the one you recite it slowly, so you could understand what you're reciting. Wal-hadar means that you recite it quick, but with knowing and understanding the meaning behind it. What tadweer means between reciting it quickly and reciting it slowly. This is a stage that you can recite, but understand also what you're reciting. And then al-tahqiq and zamzama, all these are stages in the Quran al-Kareem when you recite it, when you read it. When you sit and you recite the Quran al-Kareem and you're going to feel that this words of the Quran al-Kareem is not, no human can say it. And this is coming directly, you understand that you're receiving the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. You're receiving the meanings directly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deliver this message of the Quran al-Kareem to your heart directly. And you could even feel it that without even studying from books or something, because you will, the relationship is between you, Allah, and your heart directly. So, Al-Quran al-Kareem, when you recite it, so you, for instance, when you recite for understanding, or when you recite also to memorize, that we can move between reciting it quickly, which is hadr, or reciting it slowly so you can understand, and you could move between both. To be polite, the etiquette of recitation of the Quran al-Kareem, number one, you need to be on wudu when you start reciting the Quran al-Kareem, because you keep in mind that you're reciting the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should be in a clean space, in a clean place, and the best place it will be the masjid. And also, you need to face al-Kaaba when you recite the Quran al-Kareem. And when you should say before you recite the Quran al-Kareem, "A'udhu billahi as-sami' al-alim, wa a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim," before you start, because to keep the devil away from you, you need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep the devil away from you by this. "A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim." They mentioned that you should recite to understand and to know what the meaning behind what you're reciting. And also keep in mind that when you recite, that whenever you come to reverses about paradise, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it. And when you reach the verses of the hellfire, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you away from it. So interact with what you're reciting. This way you will cry when you read about the punishment of hellfire and the punishment of the disbeliever, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you away from this group. And when you reach the verse about the believers, so ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you to be with them. So interact with the Quran when you recite. Al-Quran al-Kareem, it's a miracle of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the living miracles. All the prophets had miracles, but many of them were the physical miracles that happened and gone. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam miracle is continuing forever until the day of judgment. This is something that unique about Islam, that you have a living miracle in your hands. And living miracle that protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that no one ever or will will able to or will ever be able to change it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantee the protection of the Quran al-Kareem. So the benefit of to recite the Quran al-Kareem, that when you recite the Quran al-Kareem, you're going to be within what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mean in this verse, in the الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرْجَوْنَ تِجَارَةً لَن تَبُورَ. Whoever will recite the Quran al-Kareem and will perform with a prayer, and you spend charity from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you publicly or secretly, you seeking business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you seek in business that will never fail. You seek in business that going to be succeeded, because you're doing business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يوفيهم أجورهم ويزيدهم من فضله إنه غفور شكور. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantee that you're going to reward you for this. You're going to reward you and extra. The reward and extra. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell you extra, that you cannot know, you cannot measure what's extra going to be. They say that the extra is to see the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the paradise. The extra from His blessings, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving and the most thankful. When you do something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. Stay away from big sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all the other sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will thank you. Will be thankful for you to be in His path, that will take care of you, will protect you, will bless you. All this will come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the benefits of reciting the Quran al-Kareem, that you cannot even measure the rewards, because it's coming, the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتُهُ وَأُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you recite the Quran al-Kareem with the way it should be recited, you are from the believers. When you are from the believers, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you. And this Quran al-Kareem going to come in the Day of Judgment to intercede for you. The Quran al-Kareem going to come to you and take you straight to the paradise. The intercession will be accepted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept the intercession of the Quran al-Kareem, will accept the intercession of fasting. These two things that will intercede for you. The Quran al-Kareem and fasting. When you recite the Quran al-Kareem, you concentrate and believe in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then you're going to be within the you will be within the family of the Quran. You'll be from the Ahl al-Quran. This is you'll be within the Quran community. Quran is going to be with you when you'll be joining the other believers that they have the Quran in their hearts. So you, in the Day of Judgment, when you are in the paradise, since you recite the Quran Kareem more often, then you will be told, read, recite, and go up and recite to the last verse that you recited. So your ranks will be up and up and up in the paradise as you recite the Quran al-Kareem. As more as you recite, as more as your rank will be in the paradise. This is something that not only that, you're going to also for your family, for your parents, that you, when you recite the Quran Kareem, you're going to, the rewards will come to your parents too. When you recite the Quran Kareem, when you follow the Quran Kareem, you, then Al Quran Kareem going to take you and just land with you in the paradise. This is something that you benefit from Al Quran Kareem. As I mentioned before, also the power of your heart or the power of the hearts of the believer is more powerful than the power of the mountains. The mountains cannot handle the Quran Kareem, will be trembled, will be crushed. But your hearts will accept and Quran Kareem, and your hearts will benefit and will get more power and more connection from the Quran Kareem when you recite Quran Kareem the way it should be. So the benefits of Quran Kareem is unlimited. And inshallah, in the second khutbah, we'll talk about that. So, أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم أدعو الله عسى أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. The benefits of reciting the Quran Kareem is unlimited. You cannot measure it. The reciter of the Quran Kareem is from the great people, the great believers, and the best people, and your ranks will be higher as much as you recite. More you recite, more your ranks will be higher, more your greatness is going to be. So keep that in mind. You recite, the increase of goodness of you is going to be higher and higher. When you recite the Quran Kareem, as I mentioned, you're going to get for every letter hasana. And the hasana equal 10 times. Just calculate. I know this young people who memorize the Quran Kareem in the school, they say that they memorize the whole juz, and I just made calculation one time when they say that you memorize one juz every day, or we recite one juz every day, or the recite the Quran Kareem in 2 days. Then I calculate in a way that find that 1,080,000 hasana a day for these young kids when they sit and recite the Quran Kareem. Do you imagine that? So even if you can't do it yourself, so show the others, or because you will get the rewards of anybody who will recite because of you. When you recite the Quran Kareem, you're going to be surrounded with the angels, and the peacefulness and tranquility will be around you, and the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be on you. The recitation of the Quran Kareem will enlighten your heart, and you're going to keep you away from darkness in the day of judgment, and also the difficulties, the calamities are going to stay away from you when you recite the Quran Kareem. The reciter of the Quran Kareem is like Al-Atruja. Al-Atruja, this is a name of a fruit. Smell good, taste good, and looks good. That's a fruit has all these qualities. Smell good, taste good, and look good. So when you, and also you'll be one of the good companions. When you sit next to someone reciting the Quran Kareem and with the Quran Kareem, like good companions, you're going to get goodness from them. That you're going to, everything coming out from the sight of the Quran Kareem is something good. The reciter of the Quran Kareem is not going to fear in the day of judgment, because he's going into protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the Quran Kareem will intercede for him. No fear. No fear in that day. And that day is a day of judgment. It's a day, if you know how difficult it is, it's a lot to talk about it. But when you are with the Quran Kareem will take you away, will fly away with you, land into the paradise, will intercede for you. You're not going to stand in any difficulties or any fearness in the day of judgment. The reciter of the Quran Kareem is going to be mercy for his parents. And the blessing going to come on them with lightness and the rewards. And even if you even you are a reason for somebody to memorize the Quran or to recite the Quran good, or to bring him to the Quran, will get the rewards. The reciter of the Quran Kareem going to go to the highest ranks of paradise, and you're going to receive the blessings in the paradise because of that. The reciters of the Quran Kareem, they are envied because of their ranks, because of what they do, and everybody will like. If you know that somebody memorizing Quran Kareem or reciting Quran Kareem, you like to be with them. You like them. This is the good companions that you be with, because you'll be giving you all what they give you will be goodness. Reciting Quran Kareem, the angels going to pray for you, for mercy, for forgiveness. You imagine that the angels will pray for you when you recite the Quran Kareem. Will recite for your forgiveness, you will recite for your mercifulness. So this is something that is specifically for the reciter of the Quran Kareem. Reciter of the Quran Kareem, you're going to read and understand and stay away from the wrongdoing, and you follow the good things. This means you're going to stick with the good route of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the devils will not get near you. You recite the Quran Kareem, you are from the people of Allah. See, Ahlullah wa khassatu wa taqarrabin ilayh. This is the people of the Quran Kareem, is the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you follow, when you're obedient of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you read, you will get even closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reciter of the Quran Kareem, your rank even in this life going to be higher and higher. Everybody will praise you, will like you, will seek even that you pray for them, because you, the reciter of the Quran Kareem and the memorizer of the Quran Kareem, this is something special. Not anyone can get it. This means that when you get that, then you thank Allah for it, because this is a blessing that anybody can get it. Reciter of the Quran Kareem, from the people who memorize, or the people who remember in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember you. In His, among the angels, you will be special. Your name will be mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the angels, because you keep reciting the Quran Kareem. The reciter of the Quran Kareem, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, going to testify for you, because when you read the Quran Kareem, you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You will feel like you are with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in all his life. 23 years of prophethood, that the Quran came throughout all these years. When you when you learn also about the seerah, because the Quran Kareem comes in stages that upon the events that happened to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you like you living with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all what he'd been through. When you are clever with reciting the Quran Kareem, you will be with al-safara al-kiram al-barara. This is a higher companionship of angels, and it's a higher and higher ranks when you make yourself clever in reciting the Quran Kareem. Even if you recite Quran Kareem and you're not clever, you still get two rewards. One reward for trying, another reward for reciting. Reciting of Quran Kareem, the devils going to stay away from you, and they're going to stay away from your house. You have no room for them there. When you the house where the Quran Kareem is recited, you're protected from the devils cannot get near you. The reciter of Quran Kareem, your mind will be enlightened, and your heart will be filled with wisdom. And the knowledge going to receive knowledge directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Reciter of Quran Kareem is part of the prophethood, but without it being la yuha ilay, there is no, just it's a degree from prophethood. The reciter of Quran Kareem is not going to be ignorant, because he's going to have wisdom, and that wisdom going to keep you away from being angry, going to keep you away from doing foolish things or bad things, because you have wisdom in your heart. That Quran is a wisdom. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inspire to your heart that you're going to be your behavior will be with wisdom. The recital of Quran Kareem, your heart and your house will be filled with blessings and goodness. The recital of Quran Kareem going to give your heart fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and yourself and your soul will be pure. You're going to be trained. You're going to be fulfilled with all goodness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Recital of Quran Kareem, you're going to have all this generosity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and blessings. The recital of Quran Kareem, you're going to have this honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, the reciter of the Quran Kareem, your hearts will be pleased. You will cause ala bi dhikrillahi tatma'inna al-qulub. When you remember Allah, your heart will be pleased. Your heart will feel good. That's way much better than people who has this worldly wealth. The people who has wealth, they are not happy. You're always thinking about how to keep the wealth, how to save it. But when you got where you are content with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with recitation, the real happiness, you're going to have it. And that's the richness, that you don't need money for it. Inshallah, in the future, khutbahs will Allah help us to purify ourselves and heart and spirit. O Allah, do not let our that we have been guided, but grant us mercy from your very presence. For you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer and of my descendants. Our Lord, accept this prayer. My Lord, forgive me and my parents and all the believers until the day of the resurrection. Glory to Allah, Lord of majesty and honor. And peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family and all his companions. Praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all creations. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي للصلاة حي للفلاة قاتل الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
إهدي اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. قل هل ننبئكم بالأخسرين أعمالا الذين ضل سعيهم في الحياة الدنيا وهم يحسبون أنهم لا يحسنون صنعا ذلك جزاؤهم بما كفروا اتخذوا آياتي ورسلي هزوا. الله
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كانت لهم جنات الفردوس نزلا خالدين فيها لا يبغون عنها حولا قل لو كان البحر مدادا لكلمات ربي لنفذ البحر قبل أن تنفذ كلمات ربي ولو جئت به عبدا إن قل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم إنما يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إله واحد فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه به أحدا. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
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 السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أستغفر الله. أستغفر الله.